Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Welcome, dear learners. This is a video for the subject of education for the course of Bachelor's in Education and for the paper of Conceptual Foundations of Education. Here we are going to have a discussion on philosophical basis of education. And in this lecture, we will be discussing the educational ideas of John Dewey. This video has been recorded by Dr. Iram Khan. The course coordinator and the presenter for this video is Dr. Iram Khan from Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. The academic expert or reviewer of this video is Professor Jaseem Ahmed from Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. This video is recorded or is produced under the project DTH Swayam Prabha Channels of MHRD or Ministry of Education, Government of India. Hello, dear students. I am Dr. Iram Khan, Assistant Professor at IASC, Faculty of Education, Jamia Millia Islamia, New Delhi. Today, we are going to have a discussion on philosophical basis of education. And here we will be discussing the educational ideas of John Dewey. So let us start the discussion first with the objectives. In this lecture, we will be discussing the life history of John Dewey. We will explain the various educational ideas of John Dewey in terms of his philosophy of education. We will be elaborating the significance of the ideas of John Dewey with respect to education in our country. Let us start our discussion with a small life sketch of John Dewey. John Dewey was born in 1859. He was an American philosopher, psychologist, and educational reformer whose ideas have been influential in education and social reform. He is regarded as one of the most prominent American scholars in the first half of the 20th century. His overriding theme or the works which were profoundly having a belief in the democracy. If we see this particular theme in which he believed, we can see the influence in politics, in education or communication and journalism. So he was an ardent follower of democracy. Dewey himself stated in 1888, while still at the University of Michigan, quotes starts with that democracy and the one ultimate ethical idea of humanity are to my mind synonymous, quotes close. So you can see that with these words, how much importance he has given to democracy. He was known for his advocacy of democracy, and he actually believed in democracy in all walks of his life. Dewey considered two fundamental elements, schools and civil society, to be major topics needing attention and reconstruction to encourage experimental intelligence and plurality. Dewey asserted that complete democracy was to be obtained not just by extending voting rights, but also by ensuring that there exists a fully formed public opinion accomplished by communication among citizens and the experts, politicians, and among themselves, with the latter being accountable for the policies they adopt. So basically, he was believing in that all these politicians and experts were accountable for the policies which the citizens adopt. Dewey was one of the primary figures associated with the philosophy of pragmatism and is considered one of the fathers of functional psychology. Dewey's paper, which is titled as The Reflex Arc Concept in Psychology, it was published in 1896, is regarded as the first major work in the Chicago Functionalist School. A review of General Psychology Survey published in 2002 has ranked Dewey as the 93rd most cited psychologist of the 20th century. Dewey died in 1952. So this is a small or a brief sketch of John Dewey's life. Let us see what else is there in the educational philosophy and in the psychology of John Dewey. If we talk about the educational philosophy of John Dewey, the concept on education here is based upon the philosophy of pragmatism. Dewey believed that knowledge is resultant of action, and according to him, change is the reality of the world. Defining education, in his own words, he said that education is the continuous reconstruction of experiences. Dewey's major concept on education has been written in his books, which are titled as Democracy and Education, published in 1916, then Logic, published in 1938, and Experience and Education, published in 1938. According to him, truth is an instrument used by human beings to solve their problems. Since problems change, truth changes, and therefore there can be no eternal reality. According to Dewey, change is the basic theory of education. Facts vary from person to person. Therefore, a person develops theory on the basis of consequences of actions and experimentations. The main aim of education is to make child capable of solving problems of life with their own experiences. The aim of education is to make human life prosperous and happy. So in this way, we can say that John Dewey is called a pragmatist thinker. And if we are asking anybody to call him a pragmatist thinker, we will be correct. So Dewey was also a major educational reformer of the 20th century, a well-known public intellectual, and he was a major voice of progressive education and liberalism. While a professor at the University of Chicago, he founded the University of Chicago Laboratory Schools, where he was able to apply and test his progressive ideas on pedagogical methods. Although Dewey is known best for his publications about education, he also wrote about many other topics like epistemology, metaphysics, aesthetics, art, logic, social theory, and ethics. So we can find a lot of articles and scriptures which are written by John Dewey in all these areas. So we can say that he was a very profound educationist. Let us have a look on the educational thoughts of John Dewey, because his thoughts are very important if we are trying to explain all those things which we talk about his educational philosophy. The first one which I would like to mention is that Dewey considered experience as the central concept of education. If a child learns, actually it happens through experiences. Problem solving and applying reflective or critical inquiry to solve the problems is the aim of education. Then Dewey considered that knowledge is gained through inquiry, reflective thinking, experimentation, and fact finding. There is no ultimate truth of knowledge. more and more scientific inquiry gives birth to new knowledge. So in this way, we can say that the knowledge is refined throughout the life. Then change is necessary for individual and social developments. And therefore, education system, methods, etc. should be changed as per the need of the time. So if we are static, we are not having a dynamic perspective in our educational system, we will be lagging behind. So education is for the child and child is not for education. So basically, he is talking about the child-centered education, where we have to keep the child as the most important person and at the center of the entire educational system. Then he said that democratic society should be established on the basis of education. In an ideal society, there should be development of social feelings, awareness of duties and rights, mutual cooperation, and all these kind of ideologies should be there if we are talking about a democratic society. Then he believed in relativism. As nothing is absolute, rather it is relative, as there is always scope for change. So basically, the relative context should always be there, because nothing is going to be in the same way as it is today. Every single day is going to bring some sort of changes in different things. Then he said that, or he believed in instrumentalism. As the objects are the existence to make the work done. So basically, all the objects are only for the sake of completing or accomplishing the tasks. So to materialize ideas, we need different tools or different instruments. So he was also a believer of instrumentalism. So all these, if we consider all these thoughts and all these views which are given importance by John Dewey, we can regard him as the ardent follower of pragmatism school of philosophy, or we can regard him as a pragmatist, as a instrumentalist, a humanist, then relativist and experimentalist. Experimentalist or experientialist. Basically, he talks about a lot of experiences, so we can say that he was experientialist also. So all these kind of genres he was having all in all in him. So these are few of those important thoughts which I thought of discussing with you all while discussing the educational thoughts of John Dewey. Now, the important point is that what exactly is the curriculum or methods of teaching which were suggested by John Dewey? If we see and if we just have a look on whatever scriptures we have which give us details about John Dewey, basically they all say that Dewey suggested that the curriculum should be determined by the child's instincts and abilities. The need, abilities and interest of the child needs to be emphasized in the curriculum. John Dewey advocated that the curriculum should be very much child-centered. He believed that curriculum should include social issues, as the child is a part of society and ultimately the product of education should work for the development of the society. John Dewey stated four principles of formation of the curriculum. And what are these four principles? The first one is the principle of utility, then the principle of flexibility, then experiential. The curriculum should be experiential, based on experiences and close to life. So the principles clarify that curriculum should be the utility of the child. Basically, it should be based on the utility of the child. It can be changed as and when there is a need. It should provide ample scopes to the child to gather experiences, and every activity in the curriculum should be suitably linked with the life of the child. If we see a bit keenly, then we can find that we emphasize on making the curriculum integrated in approach and using methods like learning by doing, field visits, then the project method, problem solving method, inquiry and problem based learning. Also the experimentation, observation, critical analysis, debate and discussion in the teaching learning process were all those methods which were liked by or which were recommended by John Dewey. Dewey has also given the opinion that all learning should be particular and contextual to a given time, place and circumstances. For example, history is a traditionally taught subject where the students are not considering its relevance to the everyday experiences. At times it happens that we feel that history is actually learning of the past and we don't feel that it is going to have any relevance in our everyday experiences. So what is the use of studying history? This type of question always arises once we introduce all these topics of history to the child. So whatever may be the subject matter, it should liberate and enrich a person's life by furnishing context, background and outlook. So once we introduce any of the subjects which are basically the part of the curriculum, we have to see that how this child is going to take the subject. So there should be some context. They should understand that there is some importance of this particular subject in their upcoming life. And if we see a book which is written by Dewey, it is named as Democracy and Education. It recommends three levels of curricular organization. The first level is making and doing. The second level is history and geography. The third level is organized sciences. So at the first curricular level, making and doing should engage students in activities and projects based on their experiences, basically the past experiences. This idea is similar to what we have seen in the ideology of Mahatma Gandhi, who is considered as an idealist and a naturalist, as well as he is also considered as a pragmatist. He believes in the principle of learning by doing. There is a lot of similarity between the craft-centered activities advocated by Mahatma Gandhi and the project method of John Dewey. In the second level of the curriculum, where he recommends history and geography, which basically Dewey regards as the two great educational resources, help in enlarging the scope and significance of the child's temporal and spatial experience from the immediate home and school environments to that of the larger community and the world. So basically we are going to create a larger perspective of this child's viewpoint. If we introduce history and geography in the curriculum, then the third stage of curriculum, which was introduced by Dewey, it says that the organized subjects and the various sciences, basically the organized sciences, consisting of bodies of tested knowledge, because we know that science is considered as to be testable and the knowledge which is tested. So pragmatists believe in the broad and diversified curriculum. We can just have a look with all those recommendations and we can just make a kind of conclusion that if we are following, we are a pragmatist and we are following all those philosophical thoughts, then we should be considering a diversified curriculum as our cup of tea. So if we believe in pragmatism, then we have to endorse a more general education as opposed to a narrow specialization. Because in all sort of places, if we are giving importance to our experiences, the general knowledge and the general subjects, the understanding of whatever is surrounding us, whatever we are doing, is a must if we believe in pragmatism. So experience of the child occupies the central place in method of learning. All learning must come as a byproduct of actions. Child learns through participation in various activities. These are few of those statements which actually give us a feel of what exactly he felt about the education and imparting the education in these systems. Dewey firmly believed in learning by doing and learning by living, and always criticized rote memorization of facts and formula. John Dewey argued that thinking does not occur in isolation from social situation without experience or action. So if we get ourselves isolated and we try to learn things, we are not going to end up in a very kind of educated person, because we will be lacking all those experiences and all those actions which actually teach us. So thinking arises when the individual confronts a problem. Actual learning happens once we solve a problem. And according to Dewey, thinking is a method. It is the method of intelligent experiencing. It is connected with increase of efficiency in action and with learning more about ourselves and the world in which we live. Actually, our learning enhances. Once we learn about ourselves, we learn about the world in which we are living, our surroundings, our neighborhood, we actually learn a lot. So he says in at few of the places he has quoted that an ounce of experience is better than a ton of theory, simply because it is only in experience that any theory has vital and verifiable significance. So Dewey has regarded the child as the core of the whole educational process. Education must begin with a psychological insight into the child's capacities, interests, and habits. So these are few of those things which are very much emphasized and elaborated by John Dewey. He looks at these capacities and interests in the social context and not in abstraction. For it, for this, basically the social context alone can be not actually developed. So nobody can develop the personality in totality if the person is isolated and not in coherence with the society. And according to John Dewey, education is life itself and not a preparation for life. So throughout the life, once we are experiencing things, we are actually getting educated. So it is not that we get educated in schools or in any of those places and then we will start living our life, or kind of education which we get in schools and different centers is going to make us very much suitable for our coming life, forthcoming life. According to Dewey, whatever we learn throughout the life is the real education and should be the most important motto of education. Let us see that what exactly is the impact of John Dewey on modern education. John Dewey's philosophy on education has a great impact on the present day education system. We just have to have a greater look so that we can come out to all those points which are very much influenced by the philosophy which was taken up by John Dewey. If we see, then the present education process emphasizes on creating or constructing knowledge through experiences of the child, which was totally like John Dewey was in total agreement with this point. Then the child has every ability to construct their own knowledge. And we already say this, that there are previous knowledges which this child is having, and while making all those teaching learning processes happen, we are just making a manifestation of all those things which are already there or already present in the child. Then teacher helps the child to construct their knowledge by using the experiences gained by the learner from their interaction with the environment, the family, peer group, society, then all those people who come in contact with this child. DOE's concept of education has contributed a lot to Vygotsky's constructivist approach of learning. And if we look ahead to all those documents, the curricular documents which we had in the recent past, we can see that this constructivist approach of learning is very much adapted and has got adoption in even our NCF 2005. We have seen that constructivist approach of learning has been given a lot of importance, and it has been considered as the most important approach of learning, which is very much endorsed by John Dewey. So we can see that all his ideas, his philosophical thoughts have got some kind of impetus into the modern education system. We have to discuss few of those aims which are considered to be the aims of education by John Dewey. According to him, the main aims of education are natural development, social efficiency, cultivation of mind of individual with respect to appreciation of ideas, art, and broad human interests. John Dewey believed that the purpose of education should not revolve around the acquisition of a predetermined set of skills, rather the realization of one person's full potential and the ability to use those skills for the greater good of the society should be always in mind. So in this way, education and learning are social and interactive processes, and the school itself is a social institution through which social reform can and should take place. For John Dewey, education is a social function. Until we know that sort of society is the best, we do not know what sort of education is the best. And according to Dewey's philosophy, the goal of education is to release the human potential for growth. Growth through freedom, through creativity and dialogue is for him, all-inclusive ideal. It is ideal for him if we talk about freedom, talk about creativity and dialogues, and which are for the sake of the goodness of the society. For Dewey, the capacity to cultivate growth is the criteria for evaluating the quality of all social institutions. John Dewey believed that democracy is the social structure that contributes most to freeing the intelligence to grow, and therefore education should be democratic. We have seen earlier also that he believed in democracy to the core of his heart. So he believed that if we make the society democratic, then only we will be making a democratization of the education where everybody has the right of getting educated, and the education should be for the sake of the society. Dewey did not subscribe to the notion of freedom as complete absence of any discipline. Dewey had specific idea regarding how education should take place within the classroom. Dewey criticized the undue importance given to the curriculum, which leads to the inactivity of the student in the entire process of learning. He believed that students thrive in an environment where they are allowed to experience and interact with the curriculum, and all these students should have the opportunity to take part in their own learning. They actually have this right to construct their own learning process. He emphasized that content must be presented in a way that allows the student to relate the information to prior experiences. So whatever is already learned, we are going to make a manifestation. So that's why he has given a lot of importance to the prior experiences and with deepening the connections with the new knowledge of these prior experiences. So we are going to see that what exactly this child is knowing when he comes to like in the influence of a teacher or of a school. So whatever is already experienced by him or her is to be sensed, and then we have to see that what kind of connections with this new knowledge we can make. So in this way, the best type of learning will happen. So he advocated for an educational structure that strikes a balance between delivering knowledge while also taking into account the interests and experiences of the student. It is a continuous process of adjustment, having as its aim at every stage an added capacity of growth. John Dewey advocated the importance of education not only as a place to gain the content knowledge, but also as a place to learn how to live. So for him, education is a way of life. Education is a process which actually goes throughout the life. We get our education completed as we move into our life. So at every stage of our life, we learn a lot and we get educated. So we can't say that we will prepare ourselves for the rest of our life. Basically, we live our life to and get educated. Dewey regarded school as an institution essential to social life. To him, school is an absolute social necessity. So he has given a lot of importance to school. The school is not a place where some knowledge is imparted and an attempt is made to develop certain habits among children. It is a place where the child learns by its own experiences. Basically, a school is lengthened arm of the family. We can say it is an extended arm of the family. So there should be no sudden break in the activities of the child in the home and in the school. He has at some place he has quoted that school is a miniature society. So you can see that what exactly is the thought process which goes inside once John Dewey talks about the structure of a school. So in the beginning, the school should try to preserve and rebuild those experiences and activities which this child is already having or with which the child has been familiar in the home. And then because he says that a school is a kind of extended arm of the family, so we can see that as the family protects and takes the child ahead, all the experiences are gained. In the same way, the school is also supposed to act. So in this way, the school should provide to the child the atmosphere of the home, and then only it will be serving the purpose of becoming a kind of place where education is imparted in a way that it becomes the way of life. What is the role of teacher, which is considered by John Dewey? According to him, the teacher should be occupied not with subject matter only. Basically, only the subject matter in itself is not sufficient, but it is its interaction with the students who are present there, and what exactly are the needs and capacities of these students are also to be considered by this teacher. So just imparting the content is not the thing which this teacher has to do. Making the teaching process and the subject matter comprehended by the students does not mean that this teacher is teaching well. To teach well, the teacher must connect the subject matter to the needs, to the desires, to the interest, stage of cognitive development in which this child is in, and all those aspects which are surrounding this child. Basically, this teacher has to connect the subject matter to all these things. And within the physical, social, and political context that the students and teachers find themselves, they have to make all these experiences complete. Then only the purpose of becoming a teacher or being a teacher will be fully accomplished. Good teaching requires moral as well as cognitive perception of the needs and abilities of the student. It also requires a complete and confident command of the subject matter to reconfigure it to meet the needs of every individual student. So basically, the teacher has to see that what are those individual differences which the children are having and what are those requirements which every individual student is having. Then only this teacher is going to be successful in the process of educating the children. Then Dewey's qualification, what exactly Dewey has recommended as the important qualification for teaching, is having a natural love for working with young children, a natural propensity to inquire about the subjects, methods and other social issues related to the profession, and a desire to share their acquired knowledge with others. So these are all not a set of outwardly displayed mechanical skills. We can just see that all these are considered as to be something which is typical or something which is very much conventional. These are those things which we expect to be there in the teachers, like the natural love for working, and if they are teaching some subjects, they should be proficient and in that subject. They should be aware of the pedagogical aspect of the subject, and they should be having a kind of desire to share this acquired knowledge of them with the students or with the others. So they may be viewed as internalized principles or habits which work automatically and unconsciously. So you can say that these are those innate habits and those qualities which are expected to be there in a teacher. The teacher training courses and all those things are some of those things which should be there, but these are few of those abilities, few of those desired capacities which should be there if a person is willing to become a teacher. Teachers are responsible for disciplining the individual to understand and appreciate the existing norms and practices of a culture. So basically, this is the important task of a teacher, to understand the cultural norms and practices, and then this teacher can impart the knowledge which is related to all these things for a better understanding of the culture to this child. So the teacher is also responsible for realizing the unique individual potentials of a child, and this is something which will be helpful in creating a kind of way out in which field or in which vocation or in which area this child is going to excel and what will be the future perspective of this child. So this is also something which is very much important, a kind of task which is very much important and to be done by the teacher itself. This implies that educating the individual's creative and artistic ability as well as their ability to engage in critical inquiry and, if necessary, carry out the reconstruction of the existing social order to evolve a better society in the future. So all these things are showing that how much important role is given to a teacher when it comes to educating a child. So in this way, now we have come to the end of this lecture. We have seen the views of John Dewey, which are clearly reflected in NCF 2005, because his philosophy is very much influential whenever we talk about the modern way of education. So it talks about the construction of knowledge, the this philosophy on which a lot of other philosophies are based on and the education systems are based on is talking about constructivist approach. The teacher's own role in children's cognition could be enhanced if they assume a more active role in relation to the process of knowledge construction in which children are engaged. So basically the knowledge construction process where the children are engaged, the teacher is facilitating this process, and in this way the constructivist approach is basically used. So a child constructs his or her knowledge while engaged in the process of learning, allowing children to ask questions that require them to relate what they are learning in school to things happening outside, encouraging children to answer in their own words and from their own experiences rather than simply memorizing and getting answers right in just one way. All these are small but important steps in helping children develop their understanding. So these are few of those things or the thought process which are very much recommended or which are very much shown by the philosophical ideals of John Dewey. In this lecture, we have seen that what sort of methods he has recommended and the role of teacher, which he has given a lot of importance. And we have also seen that the philosophy which he followed very much depends on the pragmatist school of philosophy and also humanistic philosophy, the instrumentalism. And he talks about experiences. He talks about that school is a miniature society. School has been given a very important role. According to him, school is the extended arm of the family. And as the family protects the child and makes the child much more educated in due course of his or her life, in the same way, school should also play the role so that the education which is imparted in the school becomes the way of life for this child who is and who should be at the center of education, which is recommended by John Dewey. So these are few of those important ideas, those important philosophical thoughts which are given by John Dewey. These are those references and those links which were considered by preparation of this lecture. And I hope that you can also get a lot of more knowledge if you go ahead and see these literature. I hope that this lecture is going to be helpful for you all for your studies. And you can also see that what exactly is imparted by John Dewey in terms of education, how important it is in shaping our modern educational system. And with all these words, I'll just take a leave from you all. Thank you so much. Dear students, you are watching a video on philosophical basis of education. And in this lecture, we have discussed the educational ideas of John Dewey. This video lecture was recorded by faculty at home during the national lockdown period for COVID-19 pandemic, using minimal technical resources. Technical errors, if any, are unintentional and may please be ignored. For any queries with regard to this lecture or broadcast, kindly send your email to techsupport@dth.ac.in. Thank you so much.